بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته Dear students, welcome back to the online class 10th class computer chapter number 2 Programming in C language. Today we have lecture number 10. So let's start our lecture. Today we discuss about the popular high level languages. So today we discuss about C language, C++ language, Visual Basic language, C#, and Java language. So let's start from the C language and C++ language. First of all, we know that C is the high level languages. We have two types of languages, low level languages and high level languages. In low level languages, we discuss about the machine language and assembly languages. And today we discuss about the high level languages. So in high level languages, first of all, we discuss about the C language. C language was developed in early in 1970s when IC chip was developed. C language is one of the most popular programming language which we use in our daily life or in which we use for the programming or for the games. It is a highly structured programming language that is easy to use and understand. In C language, we can write a difficult program in a very easy and efficient way. Let's suppose if you have a very big problem, or if you have the 50 or 100 instructions in a single language program. So you can write in a C language in different modules. As we learn about the modules in our previous lectures, modules means if we divide a program into our different parts, these parts are called modules. Okay, so in C language, we can divide 50 or 60 step of instructions into multiple parts. So we said that are the modules. So in C language, we can solve any problem. Let's suppose if we have to solve the problem of the, let's suppose, net salary of the army. So we can use the C language. In C language, we also developed the word processing, spreadsheets, Excels, games, etc. All these we can develop in the C language. And if we write a code of the C language in word processor, we can copy from the word processor and paste in C language and it can be executed. Now, C++ is the superset of the C language. Okay, C language is the basic language and C++ is one step up from the C language. Or we can say that the C++ is the advanced language than the C language. C++ language was developed in 1983 to 1985 at the Bell Laboratories. Okay. In C++ language, we can use the simple English-like words. Let's suppose C out, C in, printf, scanf. Okay. In C language, for input, we use scanf. And for output, we use printf, but in C++ language, we use C in for input and C out for output. Okay. And in C++ language, I provide the more facilities to easy and quick write more powerful program. In C++ language, we also use the different types of modules. And C++ language is more reliable than the C language. Because in C language, we can use the scanf, printf, or any other just semicolon brackets, but in C++ language, we don't need to use the any type of small brackets. We simply write the C in and C out. The syntax of the C++ is much easier than the C language. Okay, and the C++ language is user friendly as compared to C language. Okay, and also in C++ language, we write a huge program in a very easy and efficient way, because when we divide a very huge program in different modules, so we can write them in a very easy and efficient manner, and we can execute them easily, and we can debug our error easily. Or C language and C++ language use the compiler. What is the compiler and what is the interpreter? We discuss after a few minutes what is the compiler and what is the interpreter. But at this stage, we have to know that C language and C++ language use the compiler. And why we use the compiler for translating the language? We know that in low level languages, we write a program in binary digits, 0 and 1. And machine language is directly understood by the computer, because computer works in the 0 and 1s, and machine language also work in the 0 and 1. So that's why machine language is directly understood by computer. But as we know that in assembly language, when we write a single program, let's suppose the 5 steps of the program. So when we need to execute this program, computer cannot understand the assembly language. Then computer can use the a translator, which we call the assembler. Okay, so assembler is used to convert the code to understand for the computer. When assembler convert the code, then computer can understand what is written in the program. So as we use the assembler in assembly language, so in C language and C++ language, we use the compiler. Okay, now next is Visual Basic. Visual Basic is also a high level language, which at the earlier stage, we learn about the basic. As we know that, 2017 and in 2016 or 18, in matric class, all the students learn about the basic language. But today we learn about the C language and high level languages. So Visual Basic is developed from the only basic, and basic stands for the beginner's all purpose symbolic instructions code. Now Visual Basic is few steps up from the basic, and it is the advanced level of the basic language. In Visual Basic is a very popular programming language for writing Windows and web applications. In Visual Basic, we can write the games, education programs, science, arts, engineering, all types of these programs can be written in the Visual Basic. Okay, and it provides a graphical development environment to the programmers to develop a powerful Windows and web applications. As we know that we write a different types of codes in web designing, so Visual Basic can be used there. We can write our different types of code in the Visual Basic, and Visual Basic is much easier than the basic language. Okay, Visual Basic is much easier than the basic language, and Visual Basic is also high level language. So we know that we will need a program or a software which is used to convert the program which is written in the basic Visual Basic language into the low level languages, because we know that computer cannot understand the high level languages. So first of all, if we write a program in Visual Basic, so we have to convert the program in machine language. So which program we use? In Visual Basic, we use the interpreter. what is the interpreter, we will discuss after a few minutes. But here we must know that Visual Basic use the interpreter for translating the program from the high level languages to the low level languages, or we can say that to the machine language. Okay, and Visual Basic is the user friendly programming language. It provides the graphical user interface and it is much easier than the Visual Basic language. But C language is also much easier than the Visual Basic. Next is C hash. How we pronounce this? C sharp. Okay, first we learn about the C language, then C++, now C sharp. C sharp is a language developed in 2000 by Microsoft Corporation. Okay, C sharp is the advanced level of the C language and C++ language. And C sharp is a general purpose programming language. As we know that if we have the, let's take an example. If we have a mobile, Infinix or Huawei Y5, okay. So in Huawei Y5, we have different features. Let's suppose camera, RAM, ROM, and different features. But after some times, a company will introduce the Huawei Y5 Prime, okay? So when company introduce the new product, or when a company launch a new product in a market, so it doesn't mean a new product contains all things new. Let's suppose if Huawei Y5 use the camera 30 megapixels, okay? So it's mean when a company introduce a new product, it must contain the 14, 15, 16 megapixels, okay? Because when a company launch a new product, it will upgrade the previous product. That's what in Huawei Y5, we have a RAM 2 GB. So Huawei Y5 Prime contains the RAM 3 GB or 4 GB, okay? So it means when a company launch a new product in a market, it contains the features of the previous project. Okay, and it contains all the features of the previous product, and it contains more features than the previous product. Let's suppose if previous product has the total 5 features, okay, so it contains the 8 features, small difference. So first of all, we learn C language, okay? Then when a company introduced the C++ language in 1983 to 1985 at Bell Laboratories, so it contains all the features of the C language, but it contains much more features than the C language. And then after some times in 2000, C sharp language is developed. So C sharp language contains the features of the C language and C++ language, but it can contains the some other features which cannot we jo features humne C or C++ language mein nahi dekhe. Okay, but the syntax of C sharp language is very similar to C and C++ language. Okay, as in Huawei Y5, okay, let's suppose we use the Android or iOS Microsoft. So in Huawei Y5 Prime, we also use the iOS Microsoft. ठीक है, तो syntax जो है इनके same होंगे, बहुत ही similar होते हैं, जैसे कि C के, C++ के और C sharp के. Syntax means the rules of writing a program in a language. Okay, according to which we write a program in a language. So every language have the different syntax, means every language have different rules for writing a program in that language. But C language, C++ language and C sharp language has the approximately similar rules. Okay. Now, C++ language. Why we use the C++ language? Normally, C++ languages are used for develop web, or we can use C++ language for develop a program for games, utilities, operating systems, compilers, business applications, and web-based applications, etc., etc. Let's suppose today programmers use the C++ language. Okay, many programmers use the C++ language for writing the programs for the games, a small games which we download from the Play Store. The programmers use the C++ language. Okay, now Java. Java is also a high level language developed by Sun Microsystem. Java is also a very user friendly language, and it is similar to the C and C++ language. Okay, and Java have also the similar syntax as we used in the C language and C++ language. Means if a user learn how to use the C language and C++ language, then that user can easily use the Java language. Okay, because the syntax of C language and C++ language are same, and Java also follows the approximately similar syntax which we used in the C language and C++ language. So that's why we can say that if a user is user can use the C and C++ language, then a user can use the Java language. Okay, and in Java language, user can write all types of programs. Okay, let's suppose if we have a big program, let's suppose 20 to 30 step of instructions, and we write in the C language. So we can also write this program in Java language with similar changing, small changes, because both language has similar syntax. So both language have similar rules for writing a program in a language. So if we copy the program from the C language and paste in the Java language and do the small changing, so we can run a program in the Java language. Okay, so Java is an ideal language for network computing. It is used for writing program for a wide range of devices, computers, and networks. Okay, a few browsers that support Java are Microsoft, Internet Explorer, Firefox, and Mozilla. But in our 10th class book, we only discuss about the C language. Okay, we discuss about the C language and some operations which we performed in C language, and functions in C language, loops in C language, conditions, decision structure, some other operations which we discuss in the C language. In first year and second year, you will discuss about the C language. In BSc, you will discuss about the Visual Basic, and in master level, and you will discuss about the C++ language. We don't discuss about the Java language in C, FSC, BSc, and in master language. But if you will learn about the Java language, so you can learn from the other resources, let's suppose from YouTube or from any course. Okay, so next topic is compiler and interpreter. What is the compiler and interpreter? Compiler and interpreter, these both are the programs which we use for translating the high level languages program into the low level languages. So first of all, we discuss about the compiler. A compiler is a computer software that translates the source program into object program. Okay, as here we know that source program, that is the source program, then compiler can compile it and change into object program. Okay, now what is the source program and what is the object program? Okay, here is the two point what is the source program and what is the object program. Okay, source program consists of the statement which we written in the high level languages. Let's suppose we write a program. As we know that in chapter number 1 we write an algorithm for printing the factorial. Okay, and also we discuss about the how we print the table of a given number or grade of a marks. Okay, so you can take a single algorithm. Let's suppose we can take a algorithm of the grade, print a grade according to the given number. So a program written in the high level language in C language. So this program is known as the source program because we write a program in C language and C language is the high level language. So this program is the source program. Okay, and now when we compile it, it will convert into the object program. Object program is directly understandable by the computer processor because we know that as computer only understand the machine language means 0, 1 binary digits, and we know that computer works in only 0 and 1. Computer cannot understand these printf, scanf, c in, c out. Okay, so we have to convert it in machine language. So compiler convert the source program into the object program. As we only understand the source program and computer only understand the object program, but when our compiler translate the source program into the object program, human was unable to read and understand because it consists of zeros and one. Human can only understand the source program. Okay, let's take another example. Another example is print a table of a number. Okay, if we print a table of the given number, so when we write a program for this problem in a C language, so that is called the source program. Okay, now what is the extensions which we use for the source program and object program? Now when a compiler compile the source program and change into object program, so if we